Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jyoti Dogra and in this video I will be discussing about some combinations that can give problems in married life. So you have to check these combinations in your chart so that you can do remedies beforehand and you do not get into problems, because that is why we use astrology, okay? So if you want to have a personalized reading with me, you can book an appointment for the same on the links mentioned in the description box below. You can also follow me on my Instagram. So let us start with the video. Firstly, you have to find your Badikesh planet. Now, what is a Badikesh planet? If you are a dual Lagna, if this is your Lagna, and if the Lagna is a dual sign, which means if it is a Gemini written here, I mean it is Gemini, Virgo, Sagittarius or Pisces, then you are a dual Lagna, okay? And in this case, your seventh lord will become your Badikesh planet. So whatever sign is present in the seventh house, you have to check the lord of the seventh house, and that becomes the Badikesh planet for you. Next, if you are a Sthir, that is your fixed Lagna, which means it is 2 written here Taurus, or 5 written here Leo, or 11 written here Aquarius or Scorpio, 8 written here, then you become a fixed Lagna, okay? And in this case, your ninth lord, whatever it is, becomes your Badikesh, okay? Next, if you are Achar Lagna, which means you are a movable Lagna, which means you have 1 written here Aries or Cancer ascendant or Libra ascendant or Capricorn ascendant, in this case your 11th lord becomes your Badikesh, okay? So you have to find your Badikesh, whatever it is. Now if your Badikesh planet makes any connection with your 11th house or 11th lord, which means if your Badikesh planet, whatever it is, 7th lord or 9th or 11th, if it is sitting in the 11th house, or if it is the making any connection with the 11th lord, or if it is sitting in the 7th house or making any connection with the 7th lord, then there it gives some problems in your married life, okay? Next, you have to see if your moon makes any connection with Rahu, Ketu or Saturn, it gives troubles in married life. And moon with Rahu or Saturn or Ketu also gives psychological disorders, okay? So this disturbs your mental peace, because moon is mind and Saturn, Rahu or Ketu afflicts it, okay? So it also is an indication of some kind of stress in your married life. Next, if your 7th lord, now this is the 7th house, and whenever your 7th lord goes into 6th house, 8th house or 12th house, it gives problem. And especially in the 12th house, it is a severe case of problems, okay? So this you have to take care. Whenever your 5th lord is in the 7th house or 7th lord is in the 5th house, whenever this parivartan happens, even then there is a problem with marriage and with the children also. Now this is also one very good indication of love marriage, but it also gives some problem in your married life. Now whenever you have your second lord being a retrograde, now suppose you have 1, 2, and here you have Venus, and Venus is placed in the second house but it is retrograde, okay? So whenever a retrograde planet is sitting in the second house or the seventh house, suppose you have Saturn here and Saturn is retrograde. So whenever you have a retrograde planet sitting in the second house or seventh house, or if the lord of the second or the seventh house is a retrograde planet, even then it gives problems in married life, okay? Because retrograde shows doing something more than once, okay? So then it can give a problem. Now when we have seventh lord in dual sign, now suppose it is a Taurus in seventh house, so the lord is Venus, and we have Venus sitting in the 8th house. Now first of all, it is sitting in the Trig house, 8th house, and then Venus is sitting in a dual sign. So whenever your 7th lord is sitting in dual sign, or whenever you have a dual planet like Jupiter or Venus sitting in your 7th house, then it gives some problems in married life, okay? So whenever your 7th lord is sitting in dual house, or if your 7th house is occupied by a dual planet, then it gives some problems, because dual is duality, okay? And whenever a dual sign is linked with 5th house, it can give twins. If it is linked with 10th house, it can give 2 careers simultaneously. Whenever it is linked with the 7th house, it can give 2 marriages, okay? Not always, the whole chart has to be checked for this one, but it can give 2 marriages, okay? And it gives some turbulence in marriage also. Now whenever Saturn and Mars are in 1-7 axis, so suppose Saturn is here and Mars is here, and they are in 1-7 axis. Both are at a distance of 1 and 7 to each other. I mean, Saturn is 7 places from Mars and Mars is 7 places from Saturn. Okay, so then it can give some problem in your married life. Whatever it is, if Saturn is here, Mars is here, whenever they are in opposite to each other, it gives problems in married life. Even when Saturn and Mars are sitting together, it gives problems in married life. Okay, also if you have Saturn and Mars sitting together, if you are a female, you have to find a partner. If there is no benefic aspect, you will be the one who will be finding partner for yourself, rather than someone coming walking up to you. You have to go out and you have to find a partner. Instead of being found, you have to find. Okay, so that is something. In Saturn and Mars conjunction also give properties in life. So some real estate will be there in your name, in your life, okay? If there is no affliction. Also, Saturn and Mars gives a mature spouse. Either he will be mature in age or he will be, looks-wise, he'll be very mature. And he'll be very conservative kind of a person. Very akadu, okay? Narrow-minded person. So this all comes with it. And whenever you have Saturn and Mars in 2-12 axis, suppose you have Saturn here and Mars here. So Saturn is 2 places from Mars, okay, and Mars is 12 places from Saturn. So whenever they are in 2-12 axis, even then it can give problems in your married life. Okay, whenever Saturn makes a relation with Venus or Sun, okay, or with Moon. Now whenever Saturn makes a relation with Moon, Venus, or Sun through conjunction aspect, okay, it gives problems in married life. Because Venus is what? Venus is your relationship. Moon is what? It's your mind. What is Sun? Sun is your confidence in life, okay? So it will give some problems there. Now whenever you have Venus and Ketu together, this is one more indication. Whenever you have Venus and Ketu conjunction, okay, or Venus or Ketu is having any connection with the seventh lord. So whenever you have Venus and Ketu together, or Ketu is with seventh lord, mind you. Okay, whenever Ketu is with the seventh lord, okay, or Ketu is in trine with Venus or seventh lord, it gives problems in married life. Okay, so this you have to take care. Also, it is told that Venus and Ketu conjunction person should never find spouse for themselves. They should, let other people choose their partner. I mean, family or someone. Because when you have Ketu, it is a headless planet. You don't know what you want in a spouse. You rush into a marriage and then later on you regret. Okay, and when you have Venus and Rahu, you're too much obsessed about your partner. And too much obsession about any person or seeking perfection will lead you nowhere, and ultimately you will be suffering in relationships. So whenever you have Venus Ketu, Venus Rahu, you should be very, very careful with choosing your partner. Okay, now next is whenever you have Lagnesh and the seventh lord. Okay, whatever your Lagnesh is, suppose it is Aquarius ascendant, so Lagnesh is Saturn. And whenever you have Lagnesh and the seventh lord, and in this case seventh lord will be Sun. So whenever Lagnesh and the seventh lord are in 2-12 with each other, or 6-8 with each other, okay? So what is this? Is 2-12, right? Saturn is 2 places from this, and Sun is how much? 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, right? Saturn is 2 places from Sun, and Sun is 12 places from Saturn. So these are in 2-12 axis. So whenever your Lagnesh and the seventh lord are in 2-12 axis or in 6-8 axis. Now what is a 6-8 axis? I'll explain. If you are an Aquarius ascendant, Saturn is your Lagnesh, okay? And what is your seventh lord? It is Sun. Now, Saturn should be six places from, Sun should be six places from Saturn. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, you have Sun here. Now, Sun is six places from Saturn. And Saturn is how many places? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 places from Sun. Okay, so Sun is 6 places from Saturn, and Saturn is 8 places from Sun. So whenever you have your Lagnesh and the 7th Lord in 2-12 axis or 6-8 axis, even then it gives problems in married life. Okay, now the one more indication for problems in married life is Venus retrograde. Whenever you have Venus retrograde, what is retrogression? Retrogression is doing something more than once, okay? If you are a Jupiter retrograde planet, what you will do, you will be very much focused, you will be over focused towards education, towards your teachers and everything. If you are a Mercury retrograde, what will happen? You will, you know, put double the efforts in the matter of communication. You will be very careful with your communication, what you say, how others will take it. So you'll be overly cautious, okay? Because you might make a mistake. When you are Saturn retrograde, you are overly cautious. You have to put double the efforts. Okay, whenever there is Venus retrograde, double the efforts in a relationship and it causes problems there, okay? So that is there. So these were some of the indications for problems in married life, sometimes divorce also. So if these are there in your chart, you should better do remedies for them, okay? And be very careful choosing your partner. So if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comment section below if this resonates, if you have these indications and if you have had some problems in your married life relationships. I will see you in the next video whenever I will make one. You guys take care. God bless you. Bye.